Keenan Jarrett Forbes, known by many as AKA, has set the bar high in the rap game and is one of the most well-known names in the entertainment industry of South Africa. Forbes is a rapper, record producer, songwriter, and a businessman. But before the glitz, the glamour, riches, awards, and success, like most of us, he had an early life. AKA was born on January 28, 1988 in Cape Town, South Africa in the Western Cape Province. His mother, Lynn Forbes, was a school teacher and his father, Tony Forbes, worked for an insurance company, while AKA spent most of his time with his grandmother in the Cape Flats, Mitchell's Plain. He also has a brother who is 5 years younger than him, whose name is Stephen Forbes. And in 1995, at the age of six, he moved out of Mitchell's Plain to live in Johannesburg with his mother. AKA and his family struggled with poverty and hold strong to their humble beginnings. Before he moved to Johannesburg, he attended Holy Cross Convent when he lived in Cape Town, and then started at Greenside Primary School after moving to Johannesburg. Later on in his life, AKA also attended St. John's College, and in 2002, while AKA was still in high school, he formed a rap group with some friends named Entity. The group consisted of himself and his friends Vice Versa and Greyhound. In 2005, the group released their first album and only album titled Royal School of Hip Hop, which consisted of one of their hit songs, First Gear. The way that a car's supposed to behave in the city from coast to coastal. Rule one, the big dogs roll with the... The album was executive produced by Slicker from the Squatter Camp, and it was nominated that year at the Coral Awards for Best African Hip Hop category. They also performed at the awards ceremony, gaining great publicity for them all. Unfortunately, in 2006, the group broke up. Forbes went on to study sound engineering at the Academy of Sound Engineering, and while at ASE, he had a side job where he made radio ads for SABC Sport. In 2006, Forbes then co-founded the production collective The Ivy League alongside two other members, Books, who had a show on 5FM The Essence, including a show on KTV. Essentially, he introduced the whole group to big names they worked with. The group included a third member, Gamza. These three were in control of the South African music industry during 2007 to 2011, as they produced hits for artists like Coolie Chana, Tlakobone by Reason, Monateso by Sugar Smacks, and Bumper, including Danky San by Pro, amongst others. Bumper was their first major hit. The crew credit Pro for opening doors for them and kickstarting their run. That one Soweto boy is P.R.O. Not gang, I've been here in Big E, you know. I see you, Pro did an interview with the Sunday Times in which he shared the story of how he got in touch with the Ivy League. The first time was at Capello in the CBD, he said. I believe that you can never be larger than life because you will never know where the next thing will come from. When that kid Keenan spoke to me, I could feel him. I was like, okay, fuck this party, let's go into the car. In 2009, AKA released In My Walk, Do It, which landed him on Hype magazine, and Mistakes. On the 28th of July 2010, Forbes released I Want It All, which is the lead single from his debut studio album, Alter Ego. The album also pre-released two singles, which were All I Know and Victory Lap. Victory Lap was successful as a top South African local radio chart. He went into business with Fifth Season, which is ran by Raphael Benza, and started being managed by Debelo Motsuane, otherwise known as Tips. From there on, Alter Ego was released on the 23rd of August 2011. The album was certified gold by Risa for its commercial success. The album won several accolades, including the 2011 Metro FM Award for Best Hip Hop Album. Forbes won the Best Male Artist of the Year at the 2012 South African Music Awards. He was nominated with Jimmy Dlotlo. But anyway, as we all know that the culture of hip-hop is all about beef. During this time, AKA was coming up with Altido.
And went into that whole beef, you know, Glitz Gang, AKA. And that also came with the whole new era, me and Tito's, because went head-to-head for a couple years, a couple songs.
Got physical even.
Yeah, got physical. Sean Page just hit me in the fucking forehead. I'm at the SABC, right?
I love hearing the story.
I'm at the SABC and I'm coming out the SABC. I'm doing my thing. the corridors and I come around the corner. Lo and behold, who did I see? El Tito and Sean Page walking towards me. I say, oh shit. But then I say, okay, boy.
It's time.
you wrote the check. Now you gotta cash it. You wrote the check. Now, you know, cash this check. I say, hey, before I could even put my shit, you know, this nigga just turned his head to the back. And the next thing I just saw black.
Anyway, with AKA's position in the industry solidified, he then carries on to make major waves as he releases one of the biggest singles to date. Jealousy.
Jealousy. So, for me, this is one of those songs that I did start to finish, nose to tail. Like from the top of, from the sample, you know, I'm very into dance music, like, but I'm talking about like house, European, and all the South African classics as well, you know, like Armand van Helden, Martin Solveig, Avicii, all of that stuff. That's my shit. I love that shit, right? And as a colored person, I really grew up with dance music and house music. You know, all of that Oskido stuff. So dance music is always a cue for me. I love to sample. You can look through the whole catalog and it's there.
As AKA was finally understanding himself and the sound he wanted to bring into South Africa, he gave us an introduction to hip hop that had elements of house and Kwaito, which is part of the reason why his sophomore album Levels became a success, which has sold over 210,000 copies, being certified 7 times platinum. With some of the rapper's biggest hits like All Eyes on Me featuring Dalez, JR and Burna Boy, Run Jawzy featuring KO, Sim Dope, Control featuring Dalez, and of course, Jealousy.
I would consider myself a perfectionist, you know? I take time making my music, and I take time whether it's videos or whatever I do. I always make sure that I go the extra mile and pay attention to detail. So I suppose that's why it took 2 years to make the album. But you know, now when you listen to the album, you can understand why it took 2 years. Yeah.
The album marked a major shift in AKA's sound as he sampled dance music on most of the songs, a sound he's been refining and building ever since. According to Sony Music Africa, who distributed Levels, the album also amassed over 11.9 million video views and 28 million combined streams. But there's one song I did not mention. The song that started what is known as one of South Africa's biggest beefs in history. Yes, the Casper and AKA beef started all because of Congratulate and Doc Shebeleza. Casper Nyovest claimed that his song Doc Shebeleza was the biggest song in South African hip-hop. Number one on iTunes, not Zipiche, know the difference. Read the response from AKA, whose latest hit at the time, Congratulate, was number one on South Africa's iTunes charts. The rapper deleted his tweets in a few hours' time. Casper Nyovest's Doc Shebeleza, like many of his hits, was available for free on popular yet shady site Datafile Host. It had been downloaded over 100,000 times. It has been an AKA versus Casper Nyovest tug of war ever since. When asked on Pulse Nigeria TV what started the Casper and AKA rapper beef, AKA blamed it all on ego. To make the long story short, he said, "This is rap music, and rap music is all about I do this better than you. I got this watch, I got this." So when the art is based on being competitive, people are gonna clash, and egos are gonna come into contact.
I think beefs are healthy for the music, in terms of the quality of the music, you know. It's hip hop, it's a sport, you know. If I say I'm better than you, and you think you're better than me, we could go at it. And I'm always keen for that. You know, I can out-rap any rapper, that's what I believe. But when it comes to it getting out of the music and becoming physical fights, and that's what I don't mess with. I just think that's just stupid. But I'm all for beef, I'm all for competition, but I don't like everything else that comes with people fighting and guns and violence, and that's unfortunately where it goes to. And yeah,
A lot of subliminal tweets on both rappers' timelines were how the feud would unfold for the next few months. It took a while for the beef to reflect on Wax. In the beginning of July, Casper released his Brian Soko-produced single Pumagim. I told my story and made a fortune. I'm AKA's favorite rapper, I guess I made it on the Forbes list. Rap your vest on the second verse. AKA hit back on his Tweezy-produced song Sim Dope off his Levels album, which came out just after Pumagim. I'm in this bitch with Mandela. They put my name out the envelope, you should fuck with the winners. You got some buzz from your single, but that's just luck for beginners. Anyway, Casper has mostly played humble during the course of this beef. He's a new kid and feels the industry favors AKA, who has been in the industry a lot longer than him. On I Hope You Bought It, the opening track of his debut album Tulu Fellow, the rapper expressed how he's been unfairly treated in the industry. Advice come from niggas who don't rap, they believe in the man, which is part of the reason I believe that I can. Compilers making me struggle, they ain't feeling the man. Wish the media would treat me like Keenan and them. I hope you feeling this passionate. The two MCs forced fans to choose between them when they headlined shows in different venues in Cape Town on the same night in August 2014. Veteran rapper and blogger Slicker joined the conspiracy when he felt the beef was probably plotted for publicity. Surely this is planned. Irate AKA and Casper sat down and plotted this beef thing, he wrote on Slicker on LifeSite. Rapper Coolie Chana, who was performing at Casper's event, shared his two cents on the two rappers' feud. I'm a huge AKA fan, he's my lighty. Casper's my lighty, he said. It would be nice to be one big happy family, but I gotta be honest, I find it a little bit interesting as well. Hip hop is a competition. Big ups to them. I just hope it never gets to a Biggie and Pac situation. At the end of the day, I've always been about building. I hope eventually we get to that place where we are building again as a community. A few days later, after the two had performed in Cape Town, the beef promised to be taking the route Chana hoped it wouldn't. Both AKA and Casper Nyovest were scheduled to perform on SABC One's popular Friday night music show, Live Amp.
Multiple award winner, the biggest hip-hop rivalry Mzansi has ever seen. One night, one stage. Catch AKA and Casper Nyovest this Friday at 9 p.m. only on SABC One, Mzansi for show. Hashtag Live Amp.
When the latter tweeted that someone from AKA's camp had pulled out a gun on him, I will not be performing on Live Amp tonight, he shared on his social media. I get to the makeup room and AKA's homie pushes me. I ask him not to, and he pulls out a gun on me. I walked out, and then there and there I decided I will not do the stupid shit no more. This is not the first time I have a gun to my face. I live the gun life for real, and I choose to rap over it. Y'all wanna live that life? See where it takes y'all. Go on. So AKA's explanation to his Twitter fans was simple. I thought about it. Since I didn't do anything, I don't owe anyone an explanation. No statement from me, just hit records. Casper Nyovest opened the case. Prince Inyemba, the AKA affiliate who was accused of pulling out the gun, released a statement denying the allegations. AKA announced at the beginning of November that the charges against him and his camp had been dropped. And so towards the end of November, MTV Base compiled a controversial list of 10 of the hottest South African MCs, placing Cash Time Life's KO on the number one spot. Casper Nyovest came in second place and AKA came in third. The list enraged a lot of heads and artists. Reason, who was number six, released a short song, FWS, expressing that he deserved the number one spot. Questa released King's Speech. AKA was surprisingly calm and congratulated both Casper and KO for their positions. Casper, though, who also felt he deserved to be number one, released the diss song Beef, again expressing his frustrations on how the industry overlooks him and sending not so subtle messages to AKA. He also threw a jab at KO.
Cool with number two, cause I'm richer than number one. Yeah.
So in the beginning of December, Casper Nyovest posted on his Facebook page that he wanted to collaborate with both KO and AKA. I want to do a song with AKA and KO. Hashtag We The Power Circle. Read the post, which was accompanied by a pic of Casper Nyovest posing next to his red BMW. hip-hop fans were excited at the possibility of a song by the Three. But that excitement was short-lived as AKA's response came in 2 consecutive tweets. I have a real question to ask you. You ready? Read the first one. What's going on with these amateurs over the internet posting some messages? He tweeted in all caps, quoting a line by KO from Run Jozy, his collaborative track with the Cash Time Life rapper. At this point, it was clear to everyone that Casper had had enough of this beef and just wanted it to end. AKA clearly didn't feel the same way. At the South African Hip Hop Awards, the two sat in close proximity to each other. AKA kept poking Casper Nyovest during the awards ceremony and Instagrammed a video of the incident with the caption, "I don't talk shit on records or interviews. I'll do it in your face. I've been chirping him all night. We don't need this tracks. I'm right here and he's starstruck." AKA tweeted, "Niggas talk shit about you all year, then can't say a word when you 2 seats away." AKA's actions were condemned as crass and unnecessary by many fans. And so a few days later, one day before Christmas, AKA tweeted a picture of him and Casper Nyovest next to a swimming pool in what looked like a hotel. The caption read, "Hashtag squashed, hashtag Merry Christmas." It was finally over. Everyone was looking to new beginnings in the new year for the two. The first half of 2015 was quiet for the two, and everyone was convinced they had finally put their differences aside. Some of us had forgotten about it until the MTV Africa Music Awards held in Durban, where Casper Nyovest took the Best Hip Hop Album. TV personality Boity, who also happened to be Casper Nyovest's girlfriend at the time, stepped into the rapper's feud. When presenting the award for Best Collaboration to AKA for his Burna Boy and Deleuze assisted hit All Eyes on Me on that night, she said to the audience, "Casper wins everything anyway." She announced that AKA was the winner with no conviction in her voice, and after, she stepped away. After getting the mama's nod as the best hip-hop act in Africa, most rappers would be complacent. Not Casper. It's as if this award revealed his own potential to him. It made him hungrier, and mostly made him realize how possible it was to achieve his dreams. A few days after the awards ceremony, the rapper announced that he was attempting to fill up Johannesburg's Ticket Pro Dome, which was a capacity of 20,000 people. No local artist has filled up this venue. Even some international superstars like Trey Songz have failed. Casper's energy seemed to be more focused on filling up the dome than on entertaining AKA. So at AKA Worldwide, comes to my table in a club and slaps me. You'll probably deny this like you always do, but it's fine. Just want you to know this. AKA denied the allegation. I need to clear the record. These are false allegations. I did not slap the shit out of someone tonight. I do not condone violence, he tweeted. He later admitted to slapping the Motswako rapper. He tweeted, "At the end of the day, there are people doing their utmost to damage my reputation. Okay, yes, I did smack Nyovest, but this is crazy." He later deleted the tweet as his management instructed him. Well, that wasn't until someone actually took screenshots. On the same morning, DJ Zinhle, aka's baby mama, while being interviewed on Metro FM, shared her thoughts on the beef between the baby daddy and Nyovest. "I just don't feel anything about it," she said. "I don't know, I don't understand it, I don't get it. I don't get why people don't get each other. I don't get what's going on. I don't have a full idea of what's going on in their mind. But for me, I'm not even getting involved." After approximately a month of welcoming their baby, AKA and DJ Zinhle broke up because, according to Zinhle, AKA cheated on her with TV personality Bonang Matheba. In what could have been a gesture to make AKA jealous, she even tweeted that she was going to buy her ticket to Casper's Fill Up the Dome concert. So AKA's diss track to Casper Composure came unexpectedly. The rapper had just announced that he was releasing new music without hinting it was a diss track. On the track, which was released in the beginning of September, AKA addressed a lot of people including Casper, Ifani, Anati and Ricky Rick. After breaking up with DJ Zinhle, beefing a bit with rapper Ifani, appearing on Tim Westwood's show, his Levels album Going Gold, and of course the Casper beef, the man had a lot to get off his chest. Quotable after quotable. He reduced Casper to ashes. He revealed that Anati, who featured AKA on his track The Saga, charged them 80,000 rand for a beat, even though he was the reason the song was a hit. Consensus favored Composure, AKA had excelled. After more than a year, he had finally taken the beef to lyrics, the way beef has always been traditionally handled in hip-hop. All eyes were on Casper to respond. After 2 weeks, the rapper released Dust to Dust. The track was an extremely personal attack on AKA, which plays an expose of AKA's personal and professional life. Casper accuses AKA of being on cocaine, being kicked out of a townhouse owned by house music legend Oskido. He also accuses him of not writing most of his lyrics on Congratulate, and uses vernacular rappers to stay relevant to the hood. He digs back to a few years back when AKA was beefing with Altido and questions his friendship with Thales. Lines like, Zinhle left you in public and I don't blame you sis. They say it's nearly impossible to raise two kids. And, you getting all those deals that I turned down. I denied that Hunter's ad, I'm a businessman. You accepted 450, I denied 1 million rand, cause I'm worth more, plus you only get half of it. Among other low blows, leading to some heads declaring Dust to Dust a South African version of Tupac's Hit 'Em Up. The biggest criticism towards Dust to Dust was Casper's clumsy delivery. Respected lyricist Stogie T shared his thoughts on the song and the feud in a few tweets. The battle will go down as one of those who do you prefer battles. AKA was lyrically superior. Cass was personal AF. That's my word, he tweeted. I'm filling up the door, I'm in the field, bro. You kidding me? You're opening for Jason Derulo. And so, Boys and Bucks member Ricky Rick in a series of tweets said he felt the whole game was against the Boys and Bucks affiliate Casper Nyovest. Y'all thinking Casper's battling AKA, but the whole game is against him. When you were successful, people want you to fail. He went on to tweet that artists and DJs are siding with AKA. They supported his composure when they had called for peace when Casper released Beef. The question everybody had is if AKA will record a response to Dust to Dust, and if we will ever see the end of this AKA and Casper Nyovest feud. Like the saying goes, practice makes perfect. And in 2016, after several hits and misses, Casper and AKA finally made peace, when Super Mega congratulated him on filling up the Orlando Stadium, with fans suggesting that they take on F&B Stadium together. While Casper and AKA were the most part of Civil in 2017, Casper campaigned hard to sell tickets for the concert, and the struggle was real. The Mama I Made It hitmaker spoke openly about the money he invested and the difficulties he had securing sponsors. However, it was fellow rapper AKA's offer to perform at the concert for a cool 1 million rand. That really grated him. Casper, however, gracefully declined AKA's offer and encouraged the rapper to just buy a ticket, brur. During an interview at the time, Casper said, there were multiple ways rappers could support each other, but a collaboration between him and AKA was unnecessary because their relationship was not genuine. During the year of 2017, AKA had settled and rekindled one of his many beefs as he smoked the peace pipe with Anati, and it would later be revealed that the two would be working on a collaborative album together titled Be Careful What You Wish For. Be Careful What You Wish For premiered exclusively on Apple Music's Beats One Radio in America on Wednesday ahead of its local release. Speaking to the show's host Ebru via telephone, AKA says he ended his short-lived beef with Anati as he realized it's more important for African artists to stick together. There's so much beef, so much egos. You know it's hip-hop at the end of the day and everybody wants to be the best. I just got in a point in my life where I became a father. I started growing up a little bit more. It just reached a point when I saw him at the lobby in the BETs and thought, why are we still doing this? Let's get home and give the fans what they want, he told Ebru. Anati added that they have a good organic energy when they work together. AKA famously dissed Anati on his hit track Composure. He also gave Anati a zero rating when asked to rate South African rappers out of 10 during an interview in 2015. But that is all water under the bridge now, and the rappers are back to making sweet music together. The second single off the album, Don't Forget to Pray, was already climbing the charts in SA and was at number 13 on the Coca-Cola Top 40 charts. The album was well received by critics, the streets, and their fans. But then it didn't take long for us to get another AKA classic because, yes, in 2018, he released what could be his most successful and independent album, Touch My Blood.
Pardon me for the drama. I put niggas through trauma.
Touch My Blood. It's just really a phrase. It's like a South African phrase for, you know, connect, like dab me, you know. So I thought, hey, that's a really cool kind of way of putting it, you know, touch my blood, connect with me, you know, feel me through my music, you know, touch my blood. That's I just thought it was catchy. I thought it was really cool. I'm passionate about making music.
AKA Touch My Blood features guest appearances from fellow South African artists El Tito, JR, Young Achieve, Stogie T, Questa, and OK Malum Cool Cat, as well as an international appearance from Nigerian artist and producer Kid Dominant. Production is handled by AKA Master A-Flat, Tweezy, Tazzy, Kid Dominant, Anati, Gemini Major, DJ Maporisa, Makwa, and Books, including an additional production by Julian Maguire. Touch My Blood was certified gold by the Recording Industry of South Africa on the 25th of June 2018, just 1 week into release. On the 9th of November 2018, the album was certified platinum by Risa 4 months after its release. So Touch My Blood was originally set for release on the 25th of May 2018, and AK announced on social media that the new album would be pushed back for release until 15th of June 2018 because he needed more time to shoot music videos, release singles, drop merchandise, and confirm tour dates. Giant billboards were deployed around the city of Johannesburg to promote and build hype for the album release. He took to Twitter to share some of the images of the Touch My Blood billboards. On the 2nd of December 2016, AK released the album's first single, The World Is Yours. The music video for the song was later released on the 2nd of February 2017 and was shot in Thailand while he was on vacation with then-girlfriend Bonang Matheba. The song topped the charts and has been certified triple platinum in South Africa. Besides all of its accomplishments and this supposedly being his third and last album, this was a masterpiece. For more than just music, it was what was happening in the background that lent to his iconic status. Tracks such as The World Is Yours, Feline Versace, and the Kaifa song became instant hits, but what was most fascinating was how open he was regarding his life. And so he addressed issues with his ex in Beyonce and Daddy Issues, which also featured vocals from his daughter Kyra Forbes. He proved that he can still rap on Star Signs alongside Stogie T. He reunited with former Ivy League producer and rapper Books on Magriza alongside Questa. AKA also shouts out his colored heritage on Touch My Blood. He also squashed the beef with former rival El Tito as they gave us the song Amen. It was fitting for AKA to assume that Touch My Blood would be his last album.
I told you this was my last album because I wanted to sell records. Yeah, I thought about it and I was like, man, I gotta like have a narrative, like, cause you know when you put an album out, you gotta market it, right? So I thought to myself, what's the catch like for this? Besides the music being great, like, what's the extra thing? And then I thought, shit, I'm tired, and you know, I felt like, oh man, I should probably say this is my last album, cause that's how I felt at the time. But you know, I didn't really feel like that. And then I thought, like, man, Jay-Z did that. You know, I was like, oh, nobody in SA has said that yet. Have you noticed how many artists are saying this is their last album now? I think there's like 3 people I've heard saying, this is my last album. Hey, man, you know.
It wasn't just a hip-hop album. It was musical on a level that we hadn't quite experienced from him yet. Touch My Blood is proudly patriotic. It's about South Africa, and AK has confirmed that many times. he is able to capture a sound from the golden age of South African urban music. In 2019, AKA and DJ Zintle seem to rekindle their relationship, after Bonang allegedly cheated on him, as they are seen in a few posts together giving fans mixed signals about their relationship, with some thinking he'd do the same thing again, while some felt he's back to his senses by going back home to his baby mama. Like the first time, their relationship was short-lived and the two had broken up again, with AKA claiming a lot of people were involved in the relationship. But as usual, they remained friends mostly because they had a daughter. In February 2020, AKA took to Twitter to thank the person that shared a video of him and then 22-year-old. He said it was one of the biggest favors anyone has ever done for him. And in May 2020, AKA posted one of the first pictures of him and aspiring chef Anele Tembe looking into each other's eyes. During this year, AKA had let the Megacy know he had contracted COVID-19 and that Anele was taking care of him. During this year, we also received another album from Super Mega, which was mostly about his love for Anele Tembe. Plus, she was also a guest appearance on the project for the song Finessing. Take you shopping, you don't buy that on your knees. But if I tell you pop it, you go break it down for me. This shit can get hot. And so the album was later relegated to being dubbed an EP. Unfortunately, not a lot of South Africans digested the project well. But the album had standout hits like Heavy Drank featuring KO, Python with Don Design and Moosley, Energy with Gemini Major, and Finessing with his then fiance. To the surprise of many, AKA put a ring on Anele Tembe's finger in February 2021, showing the world just how serious he is about the relationship. And in March 2021, AKA paid the traditional lobola to the Tembe family to secure her hand in marriage. The couple then spent the Easter together at the KwaZulu-Natal coast, but tragedy hits.
Police were called to the scene outside the Pepper Club on Sunday, 11 April, after a 22-year-old woman reportedly fell from the 10th floor. She died on scene. The woman was confirmed to be Anele Tembe, fiancé of the famous rapper AKA. Details surrounding what led up to the tragedy remain a mystery.
The allegations were contained in a letter through the Tembe family lawyer sent to the National Prosecuting Authority after the entity had indicated that it wouldn't be prosecuting AKA for Anele's death and would instead hold an inquest. The letter was apparently written 2 weeks after the Tembe family was informed by the NPA in June 2022 that it would not be prosecuting AKA for Anele's death. The Tembe family believed there was overwhelming evidence to prosecute, however, it was ignored by investigators. Tembe reportedly fell to her death from the 10th floor of the Pepper Club Hotel in Cape Town in April 2021. On Friday, City Press shares that AKA and staff member at the hotel fabricated their statements to police and that evidence presented during the investigation was ignored. City Press reported that AKA and Tembe were heard arguing in the hotel and witness claimed Tembe told AKA to leave her alone moments before her fall. The witness claimed to have heard Anele Tembe drop.
7:45 Sunday morning. I received a call from the receptionist telling me there's a lady that apparently jumped. I arrived to the scene. By the time I arrived to the scene, there was paramedics and the police already. And very quickly, the police took over the scene, informed the families, and that's basically it. The police is still investigating, so from our side, we're not allowed to divulge anything. I can just say that we are very sorry about the incident. For Nelly family and for Mr. Forbes. It's a very unfortunate situation. And our condolences, and we're just hoping that clarity will come very quick and everybody can go back to their life as much as possible.
City Press also reported that there were blood marks in the hotel room indicating that the couple had fought, and that AKA had scratch marks on his back believed to have been made by Tembe as she tried to defend herself. The letter, according to the City Press reports, goes to state that Tembe's fingerprints were not found on the balcony, further proving that she was pushed off or thrown over. The report states that Temba did not die immediately, but was alive for 20 minutes after she hit the ground and that AKA did not attempt to help her.
And so I left the room, came back to the room because I had taken her phone. And obviously, you know, we continued to argue. And then things took a turn for the worst when, you know, we had gotten to the point in the argument where Anele had kind of threatened to kill herself or to, you know, jump off the balcony. She didn't say in those words, though. And I had called reception for security. And I kind of tried to remove myself from the situation again, and out of, I think maybe out of panic. I didn't want to be there or kind of feel that this was going to happen. I kind of wanted to remove myself from it, so I went to the bathroom.
AKA's socials hereafter were controlled by management and his team. We didn't hear from him for a while until we heard he'd be releasing an album with Costa Titch. Things started looking brighter. Super Mega was Super Mega again. He was navigating his way through this tragedy that just hit him, and on an interview he said Costa helped him out of a depressing state.
The stuff with Costa for me was about Costa pulling me out of my house, saying, come on man, we need you. So although it might not be the best projects, it is very vital into where we are today. Those projects helped me get to where I am today, helped me get firing again, and helped me pull me out of my depression and get back into and to where I need to be.
And so rapper AKA eventually fell in love with rapper Nadia Nagai, and the pair added that the relationship was organic and they can't recall who asked out who. But many had believed AKA had found his soulmate.
I used to, sir.
Yeah, so I'm just trying to rehabilitate her. She's been through a life of non-romance.
Yeah.
So now I have to come in and just like kind of
bring her
back up to speed. Like as in where like the game is, you know, via romance.
Yeah, no, he's definitely a lot more romantic than me. I want to have a baby.
I'm sure you do. Ooh, it's getting hot in the studio, man.
I'm getting children, personally. Professionally, I am launching my makeup brand, which I'm really excited about.
Called
Naked Without.
It's going to be amazing. Mm. And I'm very, very proud of her because she took the money out of her own pocket, did it, made it happen, dealt with all the manufacturing, importing, exporting, all of that stuff. And we hope that she begins to grow it and then, you know, kind of becomes like a mogul, like DJ Khaled or something like that.
You know?
Another one.
AKA seemed to be going back to his old self. Even better, he seemed to be going back to the AKA in 2014 as he gave us a banger featuring Nasty C, Lemons Lemonade. Lemons peaked at number 2 on the South African music chart and was certified gold in October 2022 and later 5 times platinum in 2023 by the Recording Industry of South Africa. He then released Paradise featuring Musa Keys and Gyagi. We then started hearing he'd be releasing his highly anticipated album, Mass Country. He gave us another single featuring Coolie Chana titled Prada, and after some time, he announced that Mass Country is now available for pre-order.
Okay, you go, let's go! Wherever I go, you go!
Wherever I go, you go. Some of the last words uttered by Keenan Forbes, known professionally as AKA. The 35-year-old rapper was gunned down outside a restaurant on Florida Road in Durban last night. KZN Police spokesperson Robert Echiwunda is on the scene. Let's cross over to him now for the latest. Thank you so much, Colonel, for your time this morning. Can you please just confirm what you found at the scene of the crime upon arrival?
Thank you for having us. When we arrived here last night, we found two lifeless bodies of a 35-year-old prominent musician and another 34-year-old man. who were shot and killed. That's what we found when we arrived.
The Forbes family announced that the album Mass Country would still be releasing the way AKA set out to release the album, and that they wouldn't be changing anything. And on the 17th of February, a day before his funeral, Company featuring Kid Dominance was released on all major streaming platforms. The album surpassed 10 million streams on Spotify in less than 8 hours, becoming his most streamed album. It was also certified gold just 2 weeks after its release, and 2 weeks after that certified platinum. Sony Music hosted a private brunch to celebrate the milestone and announced that the album surpassed 35,404 units, which is equivalent to over 40 million streams in South Africa alone.